Moving into the 65 sport yachts, I mean, how we've gone into the sports bridge, or should I call it the Sky Helm, as we're calling it now, because we've kind of gone back to the future in a lot of ways. It's kind of going back to our original roots of why we originally come up with the idea of a sports fly. Something sometimes people say the Predator is sometimes missing with the ultra low profile and the sleek look. It's sometimes nice to have a driving position that's slightly higher above to give, you know, to give you, firstly, better observation when maneuvering, but also just for escapism, you know, having the wind in your hair. It's like that feeling of driving a classic sports car, you know, and it's that ideal world, which unfortunately we don't really get here in the UK that often, where you've got that kind of mirror glass sea that you're out there and you're almost like breaking the glass as you're driving at 35 knots. And it's that experience and that just that feeling of escapism and that happiness you suddenly feel for that moment of like where you are, you know, the heat on your face. And what we try to achieve on the 65 sport yacht, it's a slightly smaller fly. I'll come to the social element of it in a sec, but the driving position, I'm gonna touch a base on that. So what we've designed, or our designers have gone on to, is basically this sort of center console element, which is made of carbon fiber, or has carbon fiber touches, low bucket seats, and it's basically the steering position. And the steering position, I call it kind of like a yoke. It's kind of been designed like an aircraft yoke. And the way we call it that is basically, from an observation point of view when maneuvering, the yoke from a non-seating position will basically, the steering wheel will move up in locking position. There's a joystick just to left of the wheel, so it's positioned outboard of the steering wheel. And from that, it kind of, you can stand there, maneuver the boat safely, come out of your berth, your dock, and you've got, you know, a good stood position. You can see the foredeck, the side, and the back of the boat. And then basically you touch a button and the yoke will come back down, so you're in a seated position. The seats are like a bucket seat that you would expect from a race car. And you've got the actual throttle position right there, located right by your leg. And once you're out of the marina and you've got this open ocean in front of you, you can put the throttles down. The 65 is gonna be a brilliant performance. IPS with the 1350s, even with the 1200s, but with the 1350s in particular. It's got the superchargers. She's gonna launch straight off from a standstill position like a rocket, and off she goes. The dials themselves, they're like a round with a chrome bezel shape, and we've integrated the navigation into them as well. So they'll come up with the speed and stuff like that. Some of the stuff you sort of expect from a classic or modern, ultra-modern sports car. The social element of the seat is basically you've got this aft sun pad, and basically that creates like a social seating area. It's kind of been designed like a chaise in a lot of ways. So it's, you can use it as a sun pad. So when you're at anchor and you want a bit of escapism and you want to sunbathe, or you want to just escape the family, or you want the kids, they want to escape you. You've got this area that they can sunbathe, listen to music. There's a Sonos zone up there as well, so you can, you know, broadcast your own music if you so wish. And you've got an area that you can relax and just watch the world go by. I mean, the 65 sport yacht, we've spent a lot of time designing and spending some time designing this boat. Of course, all our boats get a lot of attention, but this boat in particular, she's that little bit special. And when you finally go on board and physically see this boat for the first time, I think you're going to be overwhelmed. It's certainly got a wow factor. Just stepping onto the back of the boat, and it's got a bit of a beam on the boat, but the first thing that's going to strike you is the stair design. And it's this really cool ultra stair that's been designed, and it's the way they've curved the stair shapes, and that they've laid this, like, the lighting strips, and they are washed down the staircases. And it's going to have that striking impact that this is something different. And when you open up the garage door, if I go start from the stern of the boat, the garage is really, really cool. And it's something that is very unusual to find on a 65-foot boat, let alone on an 80-foot boat. But basically, she's 1.5 times the usual garage capacity. And when I say that, basically, she's a centralized garage. Normally on a traditional Predator, we offset a crew and a garage, and the garage is kind of positioned like a 20-degree angle. And that's normally to clear the engines and the exhaust in the engine room. But because she's IPS, it's allowed us to put a flat floor in. And with that flat floor, it's allowed us to put a bigger garage in than we normally would. We've repositioned the crew cabin further forward. Garage capacity for a 345 jet tender. And to the right-hand side of that, there's additional space, and that allows room for sea bobs, dive tanks, etc., etc. And also, we've got the option there, you can have a flexi-teak deck there. So it actually looks like not just a garage and a workable area, but an area that can be used if you don't have a tender. Take all that gubbins out and actually use it as a beach club area, where you still got your dive storage there, you put a couple of director chairs there, and it'll be dressed as an area that you can actually socialise and use. It's a really big capacity. And then moving up into the aft cockpit, a social cockpit, and a little bit more complex up here. So as standard, it'll be a bench seat with a teak deck, and then you've got the breakfast seating arrangement with a drop bar that you probably experienced on the 52 Manhattan and now the 55 Manhattan. But there's options there. And basically, the options are, basically, you can have that, a social seating area that you've seen on, which you see traditionally on most Predators, like if we touch base on the 60 Pred or the 74, which is a social seating, like a U-shaped seating area. Or you can have a wet bar option. It's a debate, really, whether you'd go for the wet bar or not. Some clients like the idea that when they've been doing the ropes and stuff, they've got an area, a wet bar, they can physically wash their hands. They've got a grill and an exterior fridge. But you have to remember on this boat, it's a galley aft design. And being an galley aft design, you literally just open the door and the galley's right there. And it's been designed in a way that we've kind of tried to make the boat as usable as possible. Not only is she sleek and good looking, but the boat is being designed and thought about on how we would use as individuals this boat. And first things first, it's got really good refrigeration capacities. So as you walk through the door, on the right hand side, you've got a fridge and a freezer, or you can have two fridges if you so wish. You've got the galley right here on your left with a little bar. You've got a TV just forward of the fridges, which can be on display or on a rise and fall. You've got this fantastic U-shaped social seating area with a coffee table that can also open up as a dining table, and that's on a high-low. And then you've got this really cool console, and the console has been designed to be a feature of the boat, something that you can be proud of to look at. It's glass bridge displays, all the elements and all the controls, as you can imagine, are all integrated into the screens themselves. And then we move downstairs, and basically each cabin, now this is where this boat is really, really cool. Each cabin has its own ensuite, and then there's also a day head. So let's say you've got a full house, the boat's full of, you know, the family, and you've got some friends on board. The guests can use the day head. So, you know, it's literally just down the stairs, and on the left is a fully functional day head. Forward VIP is very comfortable and a good size. And it has basically its own separate ensuite. You go down into the master, and the master is really quite special. There's three options essentially in this area. We call it the lobby area, if we touch from there. The standard would be a storage area. And you can either have the washing machine underneath the stairs, or you can locate it, if you go for the crew option, inside the crew cabin, or you can have it in this bar. And basically, in this bar, you can have additional fridges or ice maker, or you can have a Grand Master. The Grand Master is something really, really nice. The first boat you'll see on the 65 will have the Grand Master. And basically, as you walk down the first two steps, there's a sliding door and basically a desk or vanity unit. Now, the desk is quite handy for either to be used as a vanity unit or for those who want to work on board their yachts and perhaps using the boat as an office. And the Grand Master can be used as that, with a desk there. You can set your laptop up there, put a little refrigerator just behind you, and you can use that as a desk. Also, there's other options there. There's a lower saloon option. If it's raining, you can put the kids down there, and you can put a TV and put the PlayStation. So it gives you a bit of peace and quiet. And the fourth cabin, there's a fourth cabin option as well. It's just a single berth that just sits above literally like a little wardrobe and a little bit of a cupboard space. But she's a full beam master, as you would expect. Not too dissimilar in size, a little bit smaller than a 74, but not too dissimilar in size. It doesn't have the walk-in wardrobe like a 74, but does have a wardrobes that mirror each other with, I really like the design of this. It's kind of like this chaise design, that kind of, it's a seat, but obviously a chaise, and on the end of the seat is a vanity unit. And on the starboard side, you've got a full storage. But one thing you'll be quite striking about the 65 is basically the level of detail. It's a boat that Yeah, you know, you'd see it on a lot of Sunseekers with elements of details in the woods, etc. But it's everywhere you look. And it'll be like you look up on the roof grounds, and it's the way the designers have like integrated all the lacquer work into the roof space and the mirror that sort of comes down onto the window, onto the side of the windows, and basically integrated into the actual furniture and on the headboards, every little bit of detail. It's a very modern look, but with some elements of Art Deco into it. It's a really sophisticated look and design that obviously can be tailored to the individual taste. It's quite striking and very beautiful, but also very elegant that you'd expect from a Sunseeker. One thing we have designed on the 65 Sport Yacht is social elements of the boat. So it's areas of places you can relax, escape, and just sort of capture the sun or shade, wherever you prefer. And you see it on a lot of modern boats now, where you've got kind of a four-deck area, which has got a sun pad. We call it a Portuguese bow, but basically a four-deck seating area. And in that, there's zones, so basically different areas you can have with the music. And there's options where you can have basically cool plates up on the 65 in particular, inside the rope locker, so you can put, you know, drinks up there, etc., if you're socializing. The actual exterior seating has been designed in a way to capture some of the interior elements and bring it outside as well. So you've got this sort of like detailing into the seats itself, which is quite stunning and quite nice to look at. The aft sun pad as well has that sort of similar element as well. So you've got the foredeck sun pad, the aft sun pad, and as I mentioned earlier about the sky helm, you've obviously got an area up there that you can spend some time to socialise. So you've got all these different elements and areas you can use. So if you find on a lot of sports boats where the bulwarks, the side decks, are very narrow, this boat is very spacious and the side decks haven't certainly been compromised. And also, it's worth noting as well, it's got side access as well onto the boat. So if you've got a hammerhead dock and you're a bit nervous about having to try and board the boat from the stern, this boat actually has side deck access doors, which are fitted as standard. So you can actually use and board the boat from the side of the boat.